Digital assignment number two is on critical path method. For that, you need to have the activities followed by predecessors, immediate predecessors, and successors, and immediate successors. And when generally we'll prefer activity on arrow, not activity on node. We only prefer activity on arrow. So you need node links also, or event links, right? So as simple as that. I've given you, I'm currently explaining you with a simple example. You don't have to replicate this, but instead you have to take up a project or a process which comprises of minimum of 25 activities. So minimum of 25 activities, and you need to define the dependencies, and you have to create a project network diagram, and you have to solve that using critical path method. So as simple as that. So it's almost a unique project. So do not copy from others, because uniqueness is valued more in digital assignment number two. In DA1, we have given us 10 questions for all, same questions for all of you. But in this case, it's a unique project. So you have to take up a unique project. So if you share your notes or share your idea, then it will not be unique. So uniqueness gets, uniqueness have got a huge, weightage in DA2, right? And the deadline for this is 19th October. So it's quite a good time for this particular assignment. It's very simple. For this example, I have taken construction of a building. First, we'll do earthwork. We'll dig the earth, clear the earth for the laying footing or foundation. Then we will compact the earth, and it will make it a hard surface. That's called tamping. Then followed by, we'll apply plain cement concrete bed so that we can build down a good foundation above it. And then we cure the PCC bed. We will apply water and wait for 3 or 4 days till the concrete gets hardened. Then we will construct brick footing, which is the brick foundation. Then we will fill the earth, excavated earth. We will lay the soil around the footing, then we'll finish it. Then the building gets constructed above the surface or the ground surface. So this is an activity, and you can call this just job A, B, C, D, E, F, and then you can see the predecessors. Just pretty straightforward, because B depends on A and C depends on A and B. So which means that this is the entire predecessor. You can find out immediate predecessor. The immediate predecessor might be B, so immediately before this. And finally, for D, it is ABC and ABCD, and finally this is. And this is something like a straightforward thing, but you have to add a duration to it. Like clearing earthwork takes 1 day, hardening takes half a day, laying of PCC takes 1 day, curing takes 4 days, then constructing step footing may take 2 days. Then earth filling is just half a day or something like that. So the duration is to be added. And finally, you draw a network diagram. If you draw a network diagram, it will be like activity 1, A, B, C, D. Okay, this is all the activities. You can have it in uppercase also. That does not matter. Right, so as simple as that. Next will be a little complicated activities. Even though it has got the predecessors building up, but if you look at this, you'll be forming a loop, or not loop, you'll be forming a bifurcations, something like curing the PCC bed and assembly footing units can go together, whereas the placing footing of reinforcement can be of separate origin, or it could be a separate branch also. So almost a different thing that is like what we have done in our lecture notes, right? So this is something which is 10 activities, and creating a 25 activities may not be that difficult, right? So that's why I gave you 9 days time to complete this. In fact, if you take today, it will be 10 days time, so something. Right, so an assumption is availability of all the tools and equipments, which means that we are not talking about waiting time. So there's no waiting time, resources are available, and people can able to do it, something like that. So this is a typical example. And I'll also share you some videos that I've created for construction project management class. Do not replicate that, but instead take the idea from that and you can build up on that. Then you can create a particular project. It could be anything, automobile project, or it could be even a pass, issuing a pass in a metro also, something like that. So that's a huge benefit, right? So 25 activities, it should be comprehensive. It should almost contain minimum. I say minimum is 25. So the upper limit is, it's not there. So you can really describe a beautiful project with a lot of complexities and activities. Then you form, a relationship, predecessor and successor relationship. Then you form duration. Then you do a network diagram. Then you solve that using critical path method with all inclusive, like total float, free float, independent float, and interfering float. And also find out subcritical paths also. So entire CPM is the SMA number 2, right? So are there any doubts in this? All right, so I'll also share you the video. You can take a look at it and make yourself your time. And the deadline is strict. It's 19th October. Kindly finish it by that. 19th October, I will give 11:55 p.m. Right, so kindly finish it by then. The submission will be in Moodle, right? Like DA1, right? All right, so all the best to Val.